In results for the year, Iofina confirmed it's on track to produce 250 to 270 metric tons of crystalline iodine in the first half of 2016. The company, which produces the chemical by processing the brine water generated by the onshore oil industry, made an operating profit of $492,000 on revenue of $20.3 million, while the pre-tax loss narrowed $3.31 million. Well, Tom Becker joins me now. Tom, are these results what you'd been expecting or better?
These results are actually slightly better than what we've been expecting, and we're pretty pleased with our 2015 results. Iofina has done well to execute its business plan, create the iodine from our five iodine plants in operation in Oklahoma, and we're very pleased with how the 2015 went and looking forward to 2016.
But iodine prices, now they've been rather depressed, haven't they? I want to know how that's affected your cash position and the numbers in general, as well as your strategy as a whole.
Yeah, iodine prices, it's something we cannot control, and you're correct that the global iodine price is lower than what we had anticipated a few years ago. This is something we can't control, but we have to run our business in such a way that we run our business as efficiently as we possibly can. Obviously, the better the iodine price, the better our bottom line is going to be. But we can't control that, so we have to just run our business in a way that is prudent in times when commodity prices like iodine is down, and take advantage of situations when the iodine price returns to historical levels.
So, how has it affected you, and what contingencies do you have in place?
Well, I think a couple of things is what we've done. Just like the oil industry, it's found that when its oil prices are down, you have to really look at your business to make sure you're running as efficiently and as lean as you possibly can. And we've done those kind of things with Iofina as well. I will say that what it's probably done is probably slowed our expansion plans down. We had built four plants pretty quickly when iodine prices were much higher. In order to protect our shareholders, protect our cash position, we've slowed those kind of expansion plans down. But now that it looks like maybe iodine prices might be stabilizing, we're looking towards prudent expansion moving forward.
Now, next May, your convertible bond is going to mature. So talk me through if there's any compromise that might be made sooner than that, that you're going to need to do to restructure the debt.
Yeah, I can't say too much about restructuring the debt, except for the board is well aware of the debt and it's being due in mid-May next year. We are talking with our debt holders, who are significant shareholders with the company, and so far the talks have been very positive. And when we have some news, we'd be happy to. We will definitely share that with the market at that time.
But when you say that the news has been positive, does that mean that they're prepared to make a compromise maybe in coming months rather than waiting for the bond to mature next year?
Well, I can say that we're in talks right now, and we'd like to get this done sooner rather than later.
Okay, I think we'll read between the lines there. Now, you mentioned that you've had to slow your expansion plans down because of iodine prices. But when we have talked about your plans, you've been looking at finding suitable locations for that expansion. Where are you keen on?
So the expansion plans that we have online, we have a number of different expansion opportunities that we can do. I would suggest that future expansion plans in the near term are going to be in our core location in Oklahoma near our current operations. It's going to allow us to not only expand our iodine production, but allow us to do that in an area where we already have men on the ground, expertise on the ground, and allow us to expand with our expertise in the area to produce iodine at the lowest cost that we possibly can.
So 2016, obviously you've got those talks for the convertible bond, but what are the main plans? What's the main focus in coming months?
So one of the great things that Iofina has done this year is this is the first, 2015 was the first real year of what I'll call substantial external iodine sales. So we have not only supplied Iofina Chemical, which is a worldwide leader in iodine derivatives with its own iodine, but we also are expanding our actual raw iodine sales globally. And we look to continue to do that in 2016. The other thing that we are definitely focused on in the near term is to ensuring our brine supply at our iodine sites in the wake of some regulations that were affecting the oil and gas industry for disposal in Oklahoma, and we're working on that in the near term. And then the other thing that we're really striving to do is to really get our expansion plan set, so when the market conditions of iodine demand, iodine pricing, and other items turn around, that we are ready to expand in our core area.
So when the price of iodine goes up, you'll be all set and ready to go with your expansion plan. Look, it's been an absolute pleasure catching up. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Juliet.